Hi dears, welcome back to my Insect Pests of Crops lecture series. In this very important lecture, we'll be discussing the pests of chili and its another very important crop in India, that's bell pepper. So if you talk about chili or the bell pepper, which is generally grown in polyhouse condition, the very important important groups of pests, which includes sucking pests, which causes very serious damage, both by direct damage and indirectly by transmitting number of viral diseases, are thrips, Cyrtothrips dorsalis, aphids, Myces persica and Apis gaspii, both species, whitefly, Bemisia tabaci, and mite, that is called chili mite, Polypago tarsonimus latus. So, which in fact causes direct damage and now indirect damage by transmitting the number of viral diseases. So, those viral diseases, in fact, are represented and manifested into stunted growth, very typical upward curling, downward curling, necrosis, and all that, in fact, is considered as complex disease and is famously known as Chili Murda complex disease. So you can see here the poor growth of the plant and as a result, so poor flowering and reduction in yield. And in fact, a number of research organizations are working on management of Chili Murda complex disease by coming out with resistant or tolerant hybrids or varieties, but still, so we're unable to control this or manage this Chili Murda complex disease. So because of involvement of more number of pathogens as well as insects and mites. So causative factors for this Chili Murda complex disease are insects, mites, as well as viral diseases. So in fact, worldwide, it is estimated that about $15 billion loss. So such an important disease for this important crop. And when it comes to borer pests, so of course, our polyphagous pests, which include Silica parmigera as well as Podoprolitra, acts as flower feeders, acts as fruit borers here in this case, especially Silica parmigera. And galmiges, so in the recent past, the galmiges are becoming very problematic, which infest the reproductive parts, which includes both dipterans as well as hymenopterans. Aspandilia capsici, Aspandilia caparis, these are dipterans, whereas hymenopterans includes Goethella, Asulceta, and Ceratonura indi. So we'll take one by one. Thrips, Cyrtothrips dorsalis. Of course, it has got very wide host range, more than 100 host plants comprising of 40 families, mainly infesting chili, roses, pomegranate, mango across different families. If you see the distribution, you can see mainly Asian, including Japan, Australia, and in parts of North America. So this is where it is distributed, and wherever it is distributed, in fact, causes very high loss in various crops. So if you look at the biology of this species, so adult leaves for about 32 days and eggs are inserted into the leaf tissues. So female lays about 2 to 4 eggs per day, and about 40 to 68 eggs are laid. And they may hatch in 2 to 7 days, depending on the temperature. And there will be two nymphal instars, also called larval instars, because there will be pupal, non-feeding pupal stage in these groups of Thysanopterans. Which lives for about 8 to 10 days. Here in this case, very important thing to be remembered is that larvae acquire the virus and adults transmit that virus. It is actually Tospovirus which these groups of insects transmits. And there will be a non-feeding stage, which is called propupa, which lasts for about 3 to 5 days. And pupation generally occurs in leaves, leaf curls, under the calyces of flowers and fruits. So it takes about 15 to 20 days from egg to adult. And generally, so we'll find in a population, we'll find more number of females than the males. So as a result, the damage caused to the reproduction, the population buildup will be very high in this species. And the nature of damage includes both nymphs and adults actually sucks the sap. So from the leaf tissues or from the flower buds. So as a result of that, you can see the very important symptom which is noticed is actually the upward curling. So you can see the tender shoots, buds and flowers may be twisted and deformed. Even the flower buds you can see here, they may drop. So fresh buds become brittle and drop down. So as the flowers drop down, generally no yield reduction occurs. And in case of capsicum, you can see the scarring, discoloration and malformation of the developing fruits. So capsicum, of course, finds its now market in the five-star hotels and also in the international market. The consumer preference will become affected. So it gets reduced. As a result, the market, the price gets reduced. So more than 90% yield reduction in chili and about 11 to 32% yield reduction has been reported in case of sweet pepper. But the qualitative yield loss, you can see, is very high in case of sweet pepper, because when they feed, this type of scarring of the deformation occurs, and as a result, the consumer preference gets reduced. The most common symptoms which occurs because of thrips feeding is actually the upward curling, very clear, you can see here. So in fact, why this now upward curling occurs is because the thrips actually now feeds on the epidermal cells, palisader as well as spongy mesophyll cells. And in the usually the feeding actually gets scattered. And when they feed, because they don't, their stylet will not go deep into the tissues, the cells actually get dressed dry. And as a result of that, the upward curling occurs. The stylets of most of Thripidae can only penetrate for very short depth. Okay, whereas only few species actually goes deeper. As a result of that, we'll find this upward curling. So when it comes to aphids actually colonize in very large number. You can see the groups of aphids feeding on the undersurface of leaves. And they may be, so nymphs are adults. And adults may be winged or apterous, alates. Okay, and usually, now, aphids have got a very important character called carnicles or siphonculi, through which the wax is secreted, and they release the pheromone, which has got alarming effect to the other individuals of the same species. And through the cauda, they secrete honeydew, which is responsible for ant mutualism. Okay, so why I'm telling this is that, so if you want to distinguish different species, the very important characters which is used is actually the both siphonculi, are also called carnicles, and the cauda. So why is that? There are two important species which infests and also transmits viral disease in case of chili. So one is Myges persicae, another is Apis gossypii. You can see this Myges persicae, which is yellowish green, but vary from whitish or pale yellowish green to mid green. So depending on the parts attacked or the crop attacked. Whereas Apis gossypii is actually blackish green or dark green, mottled with lighter green coloration. So both these species, in fact, colonize, they will be found in very large number, and they suck the sap. Okay, so you can see the Myges persicae. So how to distinguish this species from the Apis gossypii is that their siphonculi are slightly swollen, okay, towards the darkened tips. Okay, at the end, it actually gets swollen, and also they have got darkened tips. And the length of this carnicle is actually 1.9 to 2.5 times the length of the pointed cauda. Cauda is actually pointed. Whereas in case of Apis gossypii, the siphonculi are actually dark colored. Okay. And the cauda is variable in color from quite pale to dusky to quite dark, but it is usually paler than the siphonculi. You can see the difference. And has got some years, 48 years. So thereby you can distinguish these two species. Of course, there are a number of other species when it comes to aphids, and they are highly polyphagous again. So if you see the Myges persicae distribution, it is mainly Asian origin, but now you can see no current corners of the world, it has reached and causing very serious damage. Very important polyphagous pest, of course. And even Apis gossypii, damaged more than 700 host plants. And also it's called melon aphid, cotton aphid. Okay, so across different families, it infests and distributed worldwide. Okay, so these two species, in fact, causes very serious losses to chili, both by direct damage and by transmitting various viral diseases. These are direct damage. You can see they colonize and they suck the sap, so from different parts of the plant. And the important symptoms which is noticed is because of the sucking the sap and release of honeydew, which actually spreads on the plant surface, and there the sooty mold actually grows, the black coloration occurs, and definitely so yield reduction occurs. Okay, so that's how the symptoms are expressed due to aphids feeding damage. So when it comes to aphid, another species, sucking pest, whitefly, Bemisia tabaci. So both nymphs and adults actually continuously suck this up. They also release honeydew, which actually spreads, sooty mold actually grows. Okay, so the direct damage is in fact comparatively less, but they transmit another very important group of viral disease called Gemini viruses. Okay, so the recently another whitefly species called Alirothrixus trichaeides was reported from India. Okay, so it is very different from now Bemisia tabaci. Of course, the damage is increasing now in the recent past, and we can expect greater loss because of this whitefly, which is generally called Solanum whitefly. So apart from those three insects pests, okay, we have another very important sucking pest, which is mite, also called chili mite, broad mite, or yellow mite, belongs to family Tarsonimidae, Polypyago tarsonimus latus. Okay, another polyphagous pest, with over more than 60 different plant families, serious on vegetables and as well as ornamental plants. You can see the distribution of course, now part of Russia and other now countries in Africa, it is distributed worldwide. So very important pest and polyphagous. So if you look at the nature of damage, infested leaves become branched with downward curling. So in thrips, you'll find the upward curling, whereas in case of mites, you'll find this downward curling. So, and also shoots grow twisted. Okay, buds are aborted and flowers get distorted. So when the reproductive parts are attacked, so generally we can expect very low yield. And even the fruits are attacked, and you can see this carrying damage, okay, and deformation on the fruits. Okay, so as a result, definitely they fetch us very less price in the market. So this is how the initial bud growth get affected and leads to the reduction in yield. So very typical downward curling, which occurs both in case of chili as well as sweet pepper. So when it comes to the biology of Polypyago tarsonimus latus, you can see the adult lays the eggs, about 25 eggs may be laid by the female, and eggs are very typical. They can be easily distinguished from other eggs of mite species, wherein eggs looks like small football. You can see here with rows of protruding white spots, very clear here. Okay, so you'll find those white spots which are protruding from that ball-like structure from those eggs. Okay, so larvae, nymphs, both actually the as well as adults sucks the sap. And so if you want to distinguish the female from the male, you can see in case of female, you'll find a faint white stripe, so which is lacking in case of males. And their dorsal surface, you'll find this white stripe. Whereas males, in the case of males, they're actually tapered, so near the rear end. That's how you can distinguish. So very clear eggs. So how they are spread in the nature? So generally, so through various modes, they may spread and cause losses. So the short distance movement or within plant distribution may occur just by walking. Whereas, so they are also from plant to plant, dispersal may occur because of wind. They may get blown from neighboring plants. And few of the countries, it is reported that they are actually depend on white flies to carry. So they latch into the white fly legs and they carry from field to field and they become problematic. So even human transport is reported wherein especially the infested seedlings are carried. Seedlings are carried from place to place and leads to very damage in the place where the infestation is not there. So that's all the direct damage these insects and mite actually causes. Indirectly, I was telling that chili murda complex disease, okay, which is both because of both direct damage as well as due to various viral disease transmitted by these insect pests. So if you look at the viral diseases transmitted by thrips, Cytothrips dorsalis, which is groundnut bud necrosis virus, GBNV also goes to chili, and mode of transmission is persistent manner, and capsicum chlorosis virus. So these viruses are causal viruses and transmitted exclusively by thrips in a persistent manner. Whereas aphids, so different species of aphids like Aphis gossypii and Myges persicae transmits cucumber mosaic virus, CMV, which is actually chili isolate, pepper motile virus, chili vine motile virus. So all these viruses are transmitted by aphids in non-persistent manner. So when the virus are transmitted in non-persistent manner, which is very difficult to control through insecticidal application, because aphids acquire the virus and transmit the virus even though they get killed because of insecticide. So virus actually get transmitted from plant to plant in very short period, and hence it is very difficult to control, manage these viruses which are transmitted by the insects in non-persistent manner. Whereas whitefly actually transmits Gemini virus, which is chili leaf curl virus, in a persistent circulative non-propagative manner, wherein the virus particle will not multiply inside the insect body. So if you look at the symptoms of individual viruses which are found in chili, which may be groundnut bed necrosis virus, which is a Toscovirus, wherein leaves turn yellow, okay, elongates, and cluster apical growth is observed with little or no fruit. Okay, so as a result, definitely yield reduction occurs. Whereas in case of capsicum chlorosis virus, you'll find the mottling or dark necrotic spots on leaves. Okay, so whereas the cucumber mosaic virus, which is aphid transmitted, you'll find the mosaic mottling yellowing. Okay, and even on the fruits, you can see now it's carrying marks on the fruits. Whereas pepper mottle virus, okay, vine banding, mosaic, puckering and mottling on the leaves and blistering on the fruits. Whereas chili vine mottle virus, okay, mosaic, green mottling and vine banding occurs. Okay, so when all these viruses are combined for a single plant, multiple infection occurs, the symptom expressed is very typical, that we call it as chili mota complex disease. And even white fly, chili leaf curl virus, you find the upward curling, puckering, bunching of the leaves. Okay, so this is famously known as chili mota complex disease. So both due to insect feeding damage, insect and mite feeding damage, as well as the complex or number of viral diseases. So we need to manage both insects as well as viral disease in order to get at least some yield, because people have tried to develop resistant varieties and tolerant hybrids or so on, but so far we have not got any encouraged results. So that's why both insects as well as viral disease has to be managed to some extent so that you can expect some yield. So as a result, IPM strategies have been developed, so which includes cultural control, nursery beds, because in the nursery itself, if the plant is infested, so generally in the main field, the infestation or infection of the virus will become very high. So nursery beds should be covered with nylon net or straw to protect the seedlings from viral infection, get carried from the from an infected field, from an insects and getting infected. Use of barrier crops in the main field, chili plants bordered with sorghum or maize against aphid strips and mites control, so if they are especially transmitted in non-persistent manner, they will actually feed and lose the virus infection capacity or the transmission ability, and they may still just cause direct feeding damage. And even intercrops like onion, garlic, coriander has been used, which actually changes the microclimate and reduces the population buildup or the viral diseases. Mulching, very important practice, with aluminum foil or polythene sheet or low-cost paddy straw or glycerin can be done in order to repel the insect species and reduce both direct damage as well as the viral infection or the transmission of viruses. Nutrient management, of course, very important, especially for viral diseases, because if you spray some of the micronutrients, the resistant or the tolerance capacity of these insect, the plants actually increases. That leads to, plant growth, which actually increases yield to some extent. So thereby the application of K2O at the rate of 105 kg per hectare or manganese supplementation, very important micronutrient, which reduces the expression of viral symptom and has a result. Okay, so some flower and fruit can be expected. Neem cake, actually very important, which actually induces resistance against insect pests and as well as viral infection at the rate of 500 kg per hectare. And very important thing is that wherever the viral infection is noticed, symptoms are noticed, so such symptomatic plants has to be collected and destroyed, because such symptomatic plants act as source of inoculum for further spread, because these insects actually has been reported that they peculiarly try to feed from an infected plant, so those plants which are showing symptoms, and acquire the virus and transmit. So that is a sort of mutualism which is found between insects and viruses. So when it comes to biological control, Lecanicillium, Lecania, or Bavaria bassina has been used against insect pests. And of course, for thrips and mites, very important biological control agent, various agencies such as mass multiply and supply, is the Amblycius species. Okay, very important phytoseed mite, predatory mite, which can be released in the field. So in fact, IHR, so the leading breeder, Dr. Madhavi Reddy, has come out with Arca Supala, Arca Abir, Arca Arita, Arca Meghana, Arca Khyati, Arca Shweta. So these are all hybrids were actually released very recently in India at nationwide, and has got some tolerance to chili leaf curl, which is especially the white fly transmitted. Okay, So we can expect some yield where the in the hot spot where the farmers are not getting anything. When it comes to chemical control, so seed treatment with imidacloprid, because so this can actually reduces the direct feeding damage, or if the virus infection is already there, so the source of inoculum is actually affected if you think of seed treatment with imidacloprid. Okay, so various insecticides have been used. So many of these insecticides are suggested and has to be used alternatively. So not all the insecticide, the same insecticide you should be used now in a repeated manner. So in order to avoid the resistance buildup. So that's why number of insecticides have been listed, which includes azadirachtin, imidacloprid at the rate of 0.3 ml per liter of water, spinosad 0.25 ml, acetamiprid, which is very effective against white flies, and various acaricides, especially for polyphagot or some musculatus, dicopal, vetable sulfur, diapentiuron, okay, vertimec, spiromycin, various miticides have been used and dried. So those are the management strategies for both sucking pests as well as the viral disease, which very serious in case of chili. So whereas the other insect pest group which infests chili are borer pests. So our ilkor parmigera and spodoptilitra also problematic, and in the recent past gall midges are also becoming problematic. So we'll take one by one. Ilkor parmigera, you can see here, it acts as fruit borer here in this case. Both flower buds and the fruits are actually made whole, and so such fruits actually leads to secondary infection and definitely not suitable for marketing. Of course, tobacco caterpillar, spodoptilitra, is highly polyphagous, acts as defoliator when the fruits are not there in the vegetative stage, and once the fruits comes in, okay, they acts as the fruit borers. So both these species can be managed with IPM strategies. Of course, IPM strategy has been developed now by various agencies. Collect and destroy the infested fruits and grown up larvae, set up pheromone trap, ileal lure or spoda lure. So depending on the species where you will find the infestation. Trichogramma chelonis, actually very important egg parasitoid, effective both against spodoptilitra and as well as ilkor parmigera. Chrysoparla carnea, jastrovi. So now we have a Chrysoparla jastrovi, which can be released at the rate of 50,000 eggs or grubs from 30 days onwards. Of course, we have HNPV and SLNPV, which has to be sprayed with cottonseed oil. Okay, so depending on the species, wherein high incidence is found, Bacillus thuringiensis, effective against both the species. And for the spodoptilitra, we have a poison baiting technique, which has to be applied at the during uning hours. Rice bran, jaggery, and water has to be mixed and kept for fermentation. And then during uning hours, that has to be mixed with chloroferrifos and applied or broadcasted in the field, and it acts as an attract and kill strategy against spodoptilitra. Apart from that, we have a number of insecticides now recommended against these two pests: amamectin benzoate, flubendiamide 6 gram per 10 liters, indoxacarb 6.5 ml per 10 liters, novaluron 7.5 ml per 10 liters, spinosad 3.2 ml per 10 liters of water. So apart from that, gall midges. So number of species, which includes Aspandilia capsici, Aspandilia caparis, which are belongs to Cecidomidae, Dipteran, whereas the elopid. So you can see here, Hymenopterans are causing damage. So very rarely you'll encounter. So most of these elopids are actually parasitoids, but here in this case, they act as pests in chili. Goethella, Asulcata, and Ceratonura hindi. So either maybe Dipterans or Hymenopterans, they attack reproductive parts. So you can see in the recent past, 10 to 40% yield loss has been reported because of these species. They attack flower buds, fruits of the plants, and causes very high yield reduction as well. So they lay the eggs in the flower buds or flower buds, and both maggots or grubs, Dipteran or the Hymenopterans, they feed on the within the flower buds and fruits, and that leads to malformation of the flower buds and twisting of the fruits. Okay, so infestation leads to flower drop, malformed fruits, reduction in yield, fruit size, and seed number. That's how they become problematic. So when it comes to management, setting yellow sticky traps. So these gall midges get attracted and stuck in. So fairly good control can be expected. Collection, destruction of the or burning of the infested parts. So we'll avoid the further spread of the inoculum. Spray of imidacloprid or beta cyclothrin at the rate of 1 ml spray during flower initiation. Okay, so that actually gives favorably good control of gall midges. So before ending, I'll ask a few questions. So which cultivar of chili is famous in Karnataka, which has got GA tag? Very important crop. So one of the places actually famous for chili in Karnataka. Which institute recently has developed leaf curl resistant chili hybrid? I told in the lecture itself. Of course, now out of syllabus question, what are the storage space which infest red chilies and its powder? Of course, red chilies are preserved and will regularly use now chili powder for various purpose, and that now preserved product is also infested with various storage space. Which are all those? Okay, so thank you very much. So if you have got any questions, you can email me and post below. Thank you very much.